Jim, we came to sweltering hot New York City with one of your new vehicles here, the Chevy Cruze, something you've got to be proud of.
Very proud of it. This is a very important launch for Chevrolet because we're going to be competing in the compact segment. It's the second largest segment in the entire industry, representing 15.3% of every sale. So the Cruze will begin shipping to dealers later in September, and we're very proud to bring it in.
Now, as a marketing guy, you've got to do a little marketing here because people are used to small cars being real basic and having maybe the crank windows and very few luxury features, but there's a different story on the Cruze.
Oh, absolutely. What we wanted to do is really bring upscale presence to the compact car class, and that's a combination that's really not available today. So the car is going to feel spacious inside, upscale amenities in the vehicle like Bluetooth, USB ports. You have navigation as options. It's really going to be upscale features in a spacious environment in a compact car class. So it's really going to be a unique combination.
So who will the buyer be? Someone that's had a compact car and wants to get some of those nicer features, or maybe someone that's downsizing a bit that's coming from who knows what, a large SUV or some other large vehicle?
Well, it's a great question. We see it as a third, a third, a third. A third of the people are going to be buying a car in this class for the first time, maybe coming from used or a certified used vehicle. A third are going to replace their current compact car, maybe a Civic, a Corolla, a Focus, an Elantra, or one of the Chevrolets. And then a third are going to be moving down from SUVs or mid-sized cars. Their lifestyles change and they want to downsize, but they still love the upscale amenities that I talked about earlier. So we think the Cruze will be perfect for each of those customers.
How do you get Americans excited about small cars?
Well, really, if you think about what can work in this segment, it's going to be terrific styling on the outside of the vehicle, and the inside a very up-level feel with all those upscale amenities that I talked about and options, but also great fuel economy. Okay, we'll have an eco model available later this year that'll get 40 miles per gallon on the highway, and that's in a compact car. It's not a hybrid. It's basically a vehicle to have a small displacement turbocharged engine, great aerodynamic features, and a lower mass, 40 miles per gallon. So we think basically the look, the fuel economy, great safety, 10 standard airbags, standard stability track, standard OnStar. It's going to be a safe vehicle, and then it's going to be really fun to drive. So you put that combination together, we have the ability, I think, to earn our way onto consideration lists and then have an opportunity to earn the business of those customers.
And some unique powertrains, too. One's going to be a 1.4 turbo, right?
Right. Yeah, absolutely. You're going to see Chevrolet focus our small and compact car lineup on small displacement turbocharged engines. This vehicle, 1.4 liter turbocharged Ecotec engine, we think it'll represent about 70% of the sales. Here's the key and the benefit is that we're able to really lower the peak availability of torque to 1,850 RPMs. That's fairly low in an RPM range to get peak torque. It's a very flat torque curve over the rest of the range. Most other vehicles, if you take a four-cylinder of one of our competitors, peak torque comes at over 5,000 RPMs. Most customers don't get to that level of RPM to get peak torque. So fun to drive, very fuel efficient.
It's actually a good New York City car, too. I mean, we're right here on the corner of Lexington and 57th. Small city car, easy to park, easy to leave on the street.
Well, you know what's interesting? Markets like this, New York, but all over the East Coast and the West Coast, the compact car segment is very large. It over-indexes compared to the rest of the nation for the reasons you talked about. In some cases, it's parking, tight streets, and so we have a real opportunity to earn new Chevrolet buyers in those markets on the coastal areas, but all over the country. So it's going to be an important one for us.
And who would your ideal conquest be? What would they be coming out of and getting into a Chevy Cruze?
Well, what I would say is we would love to earn the business from people who are currently, of course, we want our Chevrolet customers to come back. We would love to earn the business of people who are driving Civics, Corollas, Focuses, Elantras, and many others. And here's why I'm optimistic that we can do it, is we recently introduced the Chevrolet Equinox, which is a compact crossover. And we will look at people who are trading vehicles in to buy an Equinox. Over 40% are coming from outside of General Motors. They're not trading in Chevys or Buicks or GMCs. They're trading in other vehicles. So we think we can do the same thing with a Chevy Cruze.
The conquest, what you're looking for.
Absolutely. Well, we certainly have a very large owner base of Chevrolet owners. We want to see them come back and take a look at the Cruze and put it on their shopping list. And then we want to earn the business of others that are in the segment that have really been compromising in a lot of ways. It won't be a compromise with the Cruze. You get style, fuel efficiency, safety, and the vehicle will be fun to drive.
And you're thinking this is going to be a success because I know you've already added a shift at your plant and I think 1,200 new jobs, if I'm correct.
We did. We were going to build this vehicle in Lordstown, Ohio. We decided to add a third shift, several months ago. And so we hired some additional people for the plant. We're going to start with three shifts. And what we learned on the Equinox when we started building that is that the demand was much greater than we had anticipated. So we think this vehicle can be a success. We've already sold it in over 60 countries globally. Sold over 270,000. Everywhere we've introduced it, we've had good market acceptance, terrific market acceptance. So we're eager to introduce it here in the U.S. and North America.